Hey Internet, my name is Abby and welcome back to Buzz Aldrin Space Program Manager. We are still in the same version as previously, and this is because if you have listened to my interview with Ignacio, he is currently working on the rocket management system, so we can have the opportunity to change the payload and to change the Brewster rocket. And so he is working on this task, and until then we won't have any new or any great updates. So we have to deal with the same version as before, and I like to continue with this. On the one hand, I like to focus on the Apollo project on the one hand. So let me just see where we are. Have we done already something? We have done the uncrewed orbital test flight and we are currently at the orbital flight. So we want to continue with this. And for the same time or in the same time, I like to continue to go to Mars, hopefully. So I need some more scientists. This means I have to upgrade my science building at first, so I can hire more scientists and develop more interesting stuff. And so yes, I want to continue with the Apollo program at first and do the orbital flight. Let's schedule this mission and assemble it, start the assembly process, and let's proceed with this. And there are our pilots. And no more missions to schedule. Let's just end the season. Yes, I want to end the current season. And let's have a look over here. What do we have? We have the Saturn V booster as very well developed. Our Titan III booster is also very nice. The Gemini Trend Stage, 83%. The Saturn I booster also looking nice. And I think everything is pretty much in shape. Let's launch our mission. Okay, while we are now launching our mission, what have I planned? I think because we won't have so many upgrades in the near future, or no more... Oh crap. Okay, we even have left the launch pad. Okay, we won't have some game updates, so I like to keep my episode short again as I've previously did. So I will just have some missions, or not some missions, some episodes around 20 minutes per episode, and I like to just continue to, with this playthrough until we have the next version and we can finally manage the rockets. So I'm really looking forward to this. So yeah, this is my plan, just having some shorter episodes and to continue with this career mode let's play. And as soon as we have the upgraded version with the new rocket management system, we will have some fun. We will have a lot of fun. And yes, so I think this will happen in the near future or over the next few episodes. And I just have to check now. My Saturn booster needs to be improved again. Same, oh, the Apollo is still okay. What can I do? I have also started the Circumlunar Reconnaissance mission, and we still can launch this part, I think. Let's check the R&D. 86% for the Titan booster, 83% for the Gemini Trend Stage, very good. Titan II booster looking good, and the spacecraft as well. So I want to just launch this mission to do anything in this episode or in this season, because I have to wait now with the Apollo program to let's end the season to become good in shape again. Now, yes, in the next season we can launch again the Apollo mission. So we just have to do something in between, and I think flying around the moon is a good opportunity to do something. So this is what we want to do, and I hope everything will work out well. Let's prepare for this and launch everything, and I hope that we won't have any catastrophic failures or anything and lose my valuable astronauts, and I have to rehire some new astronauts. Okay. What do I want to say? Oh yes, I hope you have checked out in the last episode, as I said already, the interview I did with Ignacio about the Space Program Manager. It was pretty interesting. in general, I did this interview over a Skype phone call, and we talked about almost 2 hours. And in within these 2 hours, we did the interview for the for about 50 minutes. So it was pretty interesting to talk all about these interesting things and to hear about the upcoming rocket management system, and also how long he's working on this project. This was really amazing to me to hear that he has started so early, and how everything has become, and how he approached Slytherin, and with the early Christmas or the late Christmas gift, I called it. So it was pretty amazing to hear all the interesting stuff things from him. And yes, so it was pretty amazing. And well, during this time he also talked a bit about the rocket management system, and I'm really looking forward to this. Oh crap. Launch failed. Okay, the game seems not to be in good shape for me, because I have 2 failures in a row, but I have also some upgrades. What is downgraded? The Titan 2 booster is downgraded by 16%, I guess. And the Gemini spacecraft has received a harsh downgrade, 25%. Crazy, crazy. Yes, I know, Josephina, you're unhappy, but we will now go over to the Apollo project again. Let's try this again. Let's schedule this mission. Assemble at Nero. Start the assembly process. Yes, very good. Now I can hire some scientists. I think the upcoming missions will be mostly robotic missions, so I need space probes, rocket. I can hire 5 guys, so maybe someone who is a little bit more skilled in space probes, hopefully. Maybe you and you. Okay, let's hire these recruits. Very good. Okay, back to space complex. And what about the Circumlunar? Do we have someone working here? 77%, this is still good. 89, also good. Okay, I think we could retry this later on, but now we have to focus on the Apollo mission. I will just head back to the space complex and end the season. Yes, I want to end this, and now I hope. Wait, haven't I scheduled a mission? Oh crap. I completely forgot to schedule a mission. I thought I have done this. Oh crap. Okay, we lost one season. This is not what I expected, or not what I wanted. So let's try this again. Let's schedule our Apollo mission and auto-assign the best candidates. Okay, very good. Very good. Now, oh, I don't have my scientist yet, so I have to wait. And I hope this time... now we can launch it. Okay, let's try this again with the Apollo mission. And let's see what we can do. Launch preparations and countdown. Come on, you can do this time. Please, be so gently and fly up into space and be a success. Come on. Okay, we are ascending. Very good. I already talked a bit about the interview. This was pretty amazing. I don't have much real space flight information this week, or I haven't found anything very interesting. So on the one hand, we had in the last week the 2 successful satellite launches, or not satellite launches, one was the resupply mission for the International Space Station, and the other one was the satellite launch. Both were successful, and this was just great and amazing to watch. And I don't think that we have anything for this week. The only thing I can, or I should have to mention, I already talked about the Chinese rover on the moon. And the rover has now some issues, or it already had started with the issues, because as the nighttime on the moon approached and they have very cool temperatures there, they need to send the rover in hibernation, and there was issue with the hibernation, and so they are thinking the rover might be dead when the daylight or when the morning has arrived on the moon. So, oh, I need to do something for Josephina. So, yes, probably the rover won't be alive anymore when the next day or when the next morning has arrived on the moon, which is really unfortunate. So yeah, this is really sad. And what do we want to do? I think we want to do a Mars flyby. Let's do this. Yes, open the program, very good. And R&D Atlas Agena booster. Oh, it's well developed, okay. And the Marina 6. I need my space probe guys. Let's assign them to this. And can I still improve this a bit? Yes, I can improve it a bit. This is good. Okay, so we have something to do here. And we want to continue with the moon. What do we have? Uncrewed lunar flyby test. Let's check this. No penalization. This is good. And does the lunar flyby have? Yes. Okay, so we need to do it in the right order. Uncrewed flyby. Let's Saturn V booster. Very good. Let's schedule this mission and start the assembly process. The best candidates as usual. Okay, very good. And let's end the season and proceed to launch our next Apollo mission. Okay, it's a little bit unfortunate that the rover won't be surviving, or maybe they're not quite sure, but they are quite certain that the rover won't survive. So this is really sad. Yes, but on the other hand, the lander itself should be still alive and should be in a good shape, and it should still be able to gather some valuable data and to send back some data, and so the mission is still a success. And in the end, China has achieved to land on the moon and to bring a rover to the moon and to explore a bit the moon, so they are still a very successful mission. Unfortunately, the rover hasn't lasted as long as expected, especially because I have already talked about this. The Mars rover, the one Mars rover, has extended or was expected to have a lifetime of 90 days, and it's alive now for over 10 years. So they hope probably the same for the Chinese moon rover. And now this hibernation failure might have killed the whole rover, and this is a little bit sad, but well, it's still a success, and so yeah, it's still a great thing. And yeah, we have to wait when the next sunrise on the moon will happen for the rover, if the rover is still alive or if the rover is dead or whatever had happened to the rover. So we will find out in the near future, I guess. I haven't heard anything about the rover until now. So yes, we have to check out the news and we will see if there's something happening around or whatever will happen. Okay, we are now coming to an end with our next Apollo mission. This is very good. We are currently in our... and we have our splashdown and recovery. This is very good. So, another successful mission, amazing, very good, very good. So we can move on right away. And we have unlocked a new goal. GSA, uncrewed lunar flyby flight test, 3Q, very good, very good. And we have the maximum R&D level for the Gemini trend stage, also very nice. So I have some, wow, I have a lot of scientists now. Let me check. We need... oh, before I forget this, I need to do at first the lunar flyby. Let's schedule it right away before I forget this. proceed, and best candidates and best pilots as usual. Okay. Now I have still some scientists left over. I want to check the lunar landing. Have I developed everything? No, we need to develop the rover, so let's do this. Let's develop the rover. The spacesuit is still in good shape. So I have some astronauts left over, this is good. So I can just... Or no, not just. I will use my scientists to go to the Venus as well, to have a Venus flyby at first. Let's open this program. And we want to R&D it. The Atlas Agena booster and the Marina 5 we want to research now. Let's do this. Okay. So yes, I think I've done everything. I just can end the season and we can fly up to the moon again. What do we have here? The Atlas Agena booster, Saturn 5, Titan 3, Saturn 1. Oh, the LEM is very good, in good shape. The... Oh, wow! 54% in one go. 63 for the Marina 6 and 35 for the Marina 5. Very good. Okay, Lunar Flyby. Let's launch the mission and we want to follow it from the mission control as usual. Let's see if we are also successful in this configuration with some guys on board. I hope so. And as usual, we need to do our way to the complete order of the Apollo missions, because we can't skip just one mission and try to do the next one, because I did this in my attempt, as the Gemini direct ascent missions were a little bit bugged out, and I just skipped over to the Apollo missions, and then I had only one... I think I needed two seasons, but I had only one season before the end of the long-term goal. And so I tried to do this and I had the huge penalization because I haven't done all the previous missions. And so I failed. And because I don't want to fail again with this and I still have a lot of time, I just want to try to do as many missions as possible within the years until the end of the long-term goal. So I don't have a problem if I don't manage to do or to complete the Apollo mission until 1973 in the last quarter. And so yeah, I can take my time, but on the other hand I like to do it right away or straightforward. And this means I will do the sequence of the missions in the correct order, and I don't want to skip any missions, because I don't want to be penalized and I don't want to have some issues with the reliability because of the penalization, which might be a little bit strange. I mean, it might still be a good way to approach something if I skip a step, but this is currently the way, so we just have to play by the rules and accept the rules, and this means we have to do it in the right order, and we can't skip any missions. And we are here looking in good shape. We are now coming down, we are doing our descent, and now we have the splashdown, and let's recover it. Okay, well done. Another Apollo mission was a success. This is amazing. So, and lunar flyby, 3 crew. Very good, very good. Oh, Josephina is unhappy again. And the Saturn V booster has the maximum R&D level, okay. I have one free scientist. I think I will send the scientist to the Atlas Agena booster, just in case, so someone is working here. And I want to schedule the next mission. We had the... Lunar flyby, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Huh. Might be possible? Might be. Okay, let's schedule this mission and start the assembly process and proceed with this with our best candidates. Okay, very good. And unfortunately, we have some flight controllers. Let me just check. Okay, we need some more time. And how many flight controllers do I need for this mission? I need 5. So this might be possible. Let's check this. There's at least one. Okay, no, I don't want to do this, but I think I won't have any trouble with the flight controllers. This is very good. Oh, speaking of flight controllers, Josephine. Let's send you on advanced training. You can learn a bit more about spacecraft systems. Okay, very good. And as I said, unfortunately, we are already at the end of current episode. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked my Buzz Aldrin Space Program Manager gameplay. If you do so, please like my video on YouTube. Please become a subscriber of my YouTube channel. And also please leave me a comment about what you think about Buzz Aldrin Space Program Manager. And yes, thank you so much for watching again. My name is Abby. I hope we see us again in the next episode. Until then, see you!